In this video, we will be working with color to explore equilibrium.
My name is Jolie Wren, and I'm a rising senior at Brown University concentrating in biochemistry. I work with Lee Chong Wayne, professor of chemistry, as well as with Giovanna Rose, media services, and Carlos Perez on this project with the goal of engaging first-year students in chemistry experiments. For more than a year, I have been involved with Professor Wayne, creating and designing novel and visualized methods of presenting chemistry to a wider audience. The course, called Equilibrium, Rate, and Structure, is one of the most popular courses taken at Brown, and it contains a separate required laboratory component. With more than 400 students enrolled each year, it's important that we engage with students and adapt to a variety of learning styles. Our goal, in addition to visualizing laboratory experiments, was to develop three short interactive videos that serve as digital laboratory companions to prepare students for their laboratory experiments. We wanted the videos to be viewed as though the students were performing the experiments themselves, so the videos were shot in the first-person point of view. The experiments that students mostly struggled on, based on past performance records, were on equilibrium, thermodynamics, and kinetics. Additionally, there were limited options to engage students in green chemistry and laboratory safety, so we took advantage of the interactive software to demonstrate safe practices with these experiments. This project was mainly student-driven. Besides Carlos and myself, Jovi, Adam, Emilia, Paul, Leo, and the rest of the media services team contributed immensely to the setup, editing, and final touches to these videos. When I took general chemistry, I was often confused about the laboratory setup, which can be difficult to visualize solely with two-dimensional drawings and struggle with the confusing jargon and laboratory techniques. Professor Wang and I found that implementation of an online visualized lab supplement is long needed and is becoming more of a necessity, as students prefer a more visualized learning experience. This project was funded through the Karen T. Romer Undergraduate Teaching and Research Award, granted to undergraduates with projects that intersect different fields of study. Through this program, the chemistry department was able to collaborate with media services to ensure quality deliverable interactive videos. With support from the UJA program, we created online laboratory videos with interactive components and was given the opportunity to showcase them at the UJA symposium last August. Because the interactive components could respond to touchscreen, we linked the videos to a QR code that visitors could scan on their phones and engage with experiments at the symposium.
My name is Carlos Perez. I'm a rising junior at Brown University, double concentrating in computer science and game design. Last summer, I was working with media services and had the pleasure to work with Jolie to complete this project. I worked on the production side of the chemistry videos, so I was working with the cameras, editing the video, and adding interactive elements. Early on, we knew that we wanted there to be enough visual coverage of the lab, so no matter what was going on, there would be a camera that has a good view of what was happening. Our setup had two GoPros, one on Julie's head, the other above the lab table, and I held a separate camera on the side so I can move it around, get close-up shots, or just anything that was needed. Each lab was at least an hour long, so we knew we would have to edit and remove most of the lab to get each video to be about 10 minutes long. Our strategy was to have Jolie point out the important parts of the lab as we were recording, so in our edit, we can identify which parts we should include and which parts we should exclude. At the same time, we also want there to be enough context and enough information so students can understand what they were watching. For example, the initial plan was for the videos to not have any audio at all, or maybe music in the background. But as we were editing, we realized that it was really difficult to follow the lab without audio. It was even difficult for me to edit the lab videos because I've never taken chemistry, so I had no understanding of what was happening. So an important addition we added was voiceovers with Jolie, where once a video had been edited and finished, Jolie narrated on top of it to help students understand what was happening. I think it was a really important addition for the videos, especially in the context of trying to make the videos academically inclusive. The final step was to add interactive elements, which was a distinctive component in the proposal of the project. We used a service called H5P. Basically, all we had to do was upload the videos online, and then with the service, we could drag and drop interactive elements that would appear on the video at certain timestamps. We ended up including small quizzes, fill-in-the-blank captions, and things of that sort. The H5P solution turned out to be really simple and effective for what we were trying to do. The production side of making these videos would not have been complete without the help of Adam and Emilia. They both helped out in the filming of the videos and the logistics. We also worked with Multimedia Lab at Brown and borrowed some of their camera equipment. And of course, this would not have been possible without Jovi and Professor Lee, both who oversaw the project.
We have worked with media services even before this project and the creation of pre-laboratory lectures. Based on our past surveys, students unanimously appreciated the several online videos presented in the past and were delighted with their concision and reinforcement of key concepts. Due to unforeseeable conditions caused by COVID-19, technology has become more than essential, and we were fortunate to have these interactive videos completed in time for students to engage in the experiments miles away from campus. According to the feedback we garnered from 138 students this spring, over 70% of students agreed or strongly agreed that the interactive videos helped them visualize the laboratory procedures, provide context, and complete their laboratory reports. Some specific feedback includes, "The labs were helpful in furthering my understanding of the concepts covered in class. Transition to remote learning and getting used to the online format was a little difficult, but the demo videos as well as the lab report questions were helpful." Another student says, "I enjoyed the lab course and felt like I learned a lot, even when we went online. The online labs were a little more difficult to fully comprehend, but the GoPro videos did help in understanding how the lab was supposed to proceed." Another student commented, "It was stressful at times, but overall it was so much fun. I wish it were on campus and we actually got to do the labs, but the videos were really engaging. Online learning is prominent, and as a student myself, I believe that online laboratory videos are in high demand and will impact student learning for years to come."